Hello everyone, my name is Marissa, and I'm going to do a tutorial today for the Potomac Bead Company. For today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make this necklace that I'm calling my Riviera Necklace. Now, it's not a hard necklace to do at all. It's pretty simple and it's actually pretty fast. Once you get used to it, it's a lot of repetition, but it's pretty simple. So you should be done with one of these in no time, even if you're a beginner. It's that simple. Okay, so let's talk about our supplies, what we're going to need. For this Riviera necklace, you will need round Potomac Bead Company's exclusive RounTrio beads. I'm using the metallic sea blue. For this necklace, you will need 17. You will also need Arcos beads. And for mine, I'm using the crystal Labrador full. And you will need 16 of your Arcos beads. You will also need spiky buttons. I've chosen the color metallic sea blue. It matches my round trios. And you will need 16 of your spiky buttons. If you notice on my project, you're going to need the same amount of spiky buttons as Arcos beads, because your spiky buttons are going to be hanging or dangling off of your Arcos. You are also going to need dagger beads. On the color, I'm not too sure, but I believe it's a blue iris color, because it has blue, purple, and a little bit of green in there. These are also not the short daggers, they're the longer ones. And you will need 17 of your daggers as well. You will need the same amount of daggers as you're going to use round trio beads, because your daggers are going to be dangling from your round trio beads. You're also going to need 4mm rounds, and these are going to go in your Arcos here, in that little valley there of your Arcos beads. And the color I'm using is just a 4mm grayish color pearl. You're also going to need some seed beads. You're going to need 11 O's and 8 O's. My 11 O's that I've chosen are the Miyuki Galvanized Gold. My 8 O's are also Miyuki, and they're matte gray AB. I'm using, on this necklace, I use a cut button. I'm going to use a cut button on the one I'm going to do with you today as well. Now, I did forget to mention, for your necklace part, I also used my 4mm rounds for this part. I'm also going to use my 4mm rounds for the one I'm going to do with you today. But your necklace part, this part here, is up to you how you want to do it. I am going to use my 4mm rounds, but if you want to continue using round trios, you can. Or if you want to be more creative and use round trios and Arcos for the rest of it, you can do that as well. That's up to you. But I'm just going to use my 4mm rounds for that part. For my tools, I'm using flat nose pliers to flatten my thread end to thread my needle easier. You will also need scissors or something. I'm using the Ultra Thread Zap to cut my thread. You will need a size 10 beading needle, and you will need thread. I am using Wildfire 0.006 in green, and I have strung on my needle about 7.5 feet. You do not need to string that much thread on your needle if you are not comfortable with that. String however much you are comfortable working with. But since I do not like having to add thread in the middle of a project, I tend to use longer pieces, but you don't have to do that. Okay, so go ahead and get your materials together and I will show you what to do first. Okay, so the first thing you're going to do is get a bead that's not related to your project and go through it two times. I left a 2-inch tail and so that our beads won't fall off. Okay, so the first thing you're going to do, and I already strung on some beads on here, but the first thing you're going to do is after your stop bead, pick up a round trio, go in through, oops, one of your end holes. Doesn't matter which one, just do not go through your middle hole. So pick up your, disregard this 11-0 that I'm picking up. Okay, so we're at our round trio. Pick up your round trio through one of your end holes and let it drop. Now pick up an 11-0, an Arcos. Go down your Arcos through one of your end holes. We're not going to use the middle hole of your Arcos or Arcos at all. Now we're going to pick up an 11-0, an 8-0, an 11-0, a spiky button, an 11-0, an 8-0, and another 11-0. Now we're going to go up our Arcos through our other end hole and up. So our spiky is going to hang from our Arcos. Now pick up an 11-0. Pick up your next round trio through one of your end holes. An 11-0. Now we're ready for our next Arcos through one of our end holes. And go through it. Now we're going to get an 11-0, an 8-0, and another 11-0. Our spiky button, an 11-0, an 8-0, and another 11-0. And then go up the other end hole of your Arcos. Now, our round trios are going to look really weird until we get started on our next step. So our round trios, some of them are going to be down, some of them are going to be up. That's okay. You're going to be tempted to fix them. They won't stay, but like I said, that's okay. Our next step is going to fix all that. Now, when I started right after my this little stop bead, I started with a round trio. Round trio, 11-0, Arcos, down your Arcos through the end, 11-0, 8-0, 11-0, spiky, 11-0, 8-0, 11-0 through the other end, 11-0, and round trio. So you are going to have 11-0s on either side of your round trios. We started like this, but that's okay. Later on, when we do our other, the necklace part, we can add, the 11-0 on this side and then whatever beads we're going to continue with there. But it's just easier if you start it with the round trios. So, round trio, 11-0 Arcos, 11-0, 8-0, 11-0 Spiky, 11-0, 8-0, 11-0 up the Arcos, 11-0, and round trio. So, I'm coming out of this Arcos, get an 11-0. My next round trio, again, one of your end holes, 11-0, Arcos, down your Arcos, and pull. Eleven O, 8-0, 11-0, spiky button, 11-0, Edo, Edo, 11-0, up the other hole on the other end of our Arcos. And just make sure when you're threading your Arcos that you're going down the Arcos, your bowl, the moon look should be like this. So go ahead and do this with all 17 and all 16 of your Arcos, as well as your spiky buttons, all the way until you finish, until you end with a round trio. You need to finish with a round trio. And I will show you what to do next. Okay, so I already added all of my round trios and my Arcos. And my round trios are hanging out up like this, and this, it's looking very weird, but that's okay. We're going to fix that. And I said that you should end at a round trio. So once you've ended there, I went ahead and I did this part of my necklace, and all I did was alternate 11 O's and 4 millimeter rounds. Now this part is up to you how you want to do it, but this is how I'm doing it. So I ended with a round trio, then I started with an 11-0, 4 millimeter, 11-0, 4 millimeter, 11-0, 4 millimeter, and so forth. And this is the length that I want. So after my last 4 millimeter, I added 3 11-0s, and I'm going to do 2 more. So I want to have a total of 5 11-0s here after my last 4 millimeter. Now I'm going to take my cut button and I'm going to go up my cut button. And then I'm going to decorate the top of my cut button with 3 11-0s. And then I'm going to go down the other hole of my cut button. And I'm going to pull. And then I'm going to take 3 more 11-0s on my needle. And then here at these 5, I'm going to go through these 3 11-0s again, the ones that are closest to the cut button. The 2 that I have here right before my 4 millimeter, I'm going to leave those alone. I'm just going to go up these 3 and up the cut button, and I'm going to try to catch that first bead after my cut button, well, in my cut button. And I'm going to reinforce. This is reinforcing it. I'm going to go in through the middle bead and then through the end bead, come out of my cut button and out of those 3 11-0s after that hole. And I'm going to reinforce, whoops, I'm going to untangle my thread, and then I'm going to reinforce this one more time by going up these 3 again through the cut button, and that catching that 11-0, pull. In my cut button. And I completely forgot my fingernail. My fingernail polish was chalky, so I apologize for that. Hope it's not distracting. Going down these 3 beads. Now, these 2 beads here at the point here, I'm going to go through these 2. And then I'm going to go through all of these beads again. So that's going to put 2 threads in that part of my necklace. It's going to reinforce this. So I'm going to go off camera and I'm going to go make sure I go through every single one of these. Make sure I'm not skipping an 11-0. I'm going to go through all of these, and then I'll meet you back here right before this round trio, and I'll show you what to do after that. Okay, so I went back and I went through all of these beads and I ended here right before my round trio. And yeah, I got that last bead too. So we're right here, right at this round trio. We're gonna go ahead and go through the round trio. Only the round trio come out. The other side of your round trio only. And then hop on over to the middle hole of your round trio. And then go into hop on over again. And this time end up here on this hole of your round trio. The last hole. Now we're going to add our dagger. We're going to be working with our 11 O's again. Now we're going to be adding our daggers and our 4mm beads that are going to go here in our Arcos. So we're coming out here of our round trio. Pick up 2 11 O's. Your dagger. 2 11 O's. Let those drop and go through that same hole that you're coming out of, going through the other side in the opposite direction, in other words, and that will put your dagger there. Now pick up another 11 O. Go up your Arcos, the end hole, and only your Arcos. Do not go through this 11 O. Just go up your Arcos and pull. And that will connect these together like that. And now your round trio will stay down. This is going to keep your round trios down now. Now pick up a 4mm bead and go through. See, we're coming out of this hole of our Arcos. I picked up my 4mm. Now I'm going to go through the other end hole of my Arcos and go down. There is an 11 O right there. Do not go through that 11 O. Just come out of your Arcos and pull. And that will set your 4mm bead in that little space there in your Arcos. So we're coming out of our Arcos. Pick up an 11 O. Go through your next round trio through this, the bottom hole. We're not going to be touching our middle hole of our round trio. So I added my 11 O, I went through the round trio, and I'm going to pick up 2 more 11 O's. My next dagger. My 2 more 11 O's. Let those drop. And I'm going to go through this same round trio. I'm coming out through here of my round trio. I'm gonna go in through the same hole in the opposite direction. I'm gonna pull. And that's what I have. Now, I have my dagger there hanging. I'm gonna pick up 1 more 11 O. I'm going to go through this Arcos next to my round trio, the end hole. Be sure not to go in through any one of these beads that are connected to your spiky button. Just go through the hole of your Arcos, go up your Arcos, pull. That's going to put your 11 O in place. Pick up a 4mm bead, and I just scattered mine all over the place. Okay. So I have my 4mm bead. I'm coming out of this hole of my Arcos, the end hole. I'm going to go down the other end hole. And I'm going to be careful not to pick up that 11-0 that's right there in that grouping with my 8-0 and my spiky button. I'm going to pull. Now I'm going to pick up another 11-0. And I'm going to go through this round trio here. See, we have something in the top hole, nothing in the middle hole, nothing on the bottom hole. Go through the bottom hole. Do not go through the middle hole. Out your round trio. And that just put this 4mm in place and that 11-0 there. Now we're going to pick up two more 11-0s. Whoop. My next dagger bead. Two more 11-0s. Let those drop. And I'm coming out of this round trio. I'm going to go in through the same hole in the opposite direction. Do not catch the 11-0 that's right there. I'm going to pull. This is what I have. Now I'm going to get an 11-0. I'm going to go through the end hole of this Arcos. Be careful not to get that 11-0 that's right there. And I'm going to go up my Arcos. So that's what you should have. Now, once you're coming out of your Arcos, pick up your next 4mm bead. Let it drop. Go through the other end hole of your Arcos and go down. And be careful not to catch that 11-0 that's right underneath it. Just pull your string. Now we need to go through this round trio here. Next to this Arcos, we're going to connect it by picking up an 11-0. Your top hole has something going through it. Your middle hole is empty. Go through your bottom hole. And we're going to do all this all over again with our dagger. Okay, so do that until you get to the very end, until you get to your last round trio with putting your 11-0s, your dagger, your 11-0s, and then the 11-0 right before you go up the Arcos. Once you're up the Arcos, the 4mm bead, down the other hole, the other end hole of your Arcos, being careful not to grab any of these beads that are connected to your spiky button. Pick up, once you're out, pick up an 11-0 and go through this next round trio bead, through the bottom hole, not the middle. Okay, so go ahead and finish, do the rest of your bracelet, and I'll meet you back and I'll show you what to do next. Okay, I've come to my last round trio and I've added all of my 4mm rounds that go here at my Arcos and all of my daggers. And I've just ended here where I put in my dagger with my two 11-0s on the side, and I'm coming out of the last hole of the hole at the bottom of my round trio. So now I want to hop on over to the middle hole with my needle, just the round trio, and then I want to hop on over again to the top hole, or the first hole, depending how you look at it, of my round trio. So we're coming out here. You should be at the beginning, right where your stop button is, your stop bead is at. So now here, we're going to do the same thing that we did over here. However you did this side, you're going to do on this side now. Since I used 11-0s and 4mm rounds, that's what I'm going to do. So I'm going to start with an 11-0 And I'm going to alternate 1104 millimeter, 1104 millimeter, 1104 millimeter, and so forth. I have 17 4 millimeters, so that's what I'm going to add over here. When I finish with my last 4 millimeter and I come out of it, I will meet you back and show you how to do your loop for your cup button. Okay, so I've already added my 4 millimeters and my 11-0s. I've added the same amount that I have on this side, or maybe I don't. Looks like I need one more. 17 here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yes, I need one more. So just, there we go. So after my last 4 millimeter, I'm going to do the same thing that I did on this side. I'm going to pick up two, because I'm going to do it like how I did it over here. I have these two here at my V. So I'm going to do the same thing over here. I picked up these two. Now I'm just going to pick up a whole bunch on my needle, enough to go around my cup button. And I have not added a crystal in my cup button, so I only need enough to go around my actual button. So I'm just gonna pick up a bunch and I'm gonna try it, because I'm talking, so I can't count while I'm talking. I'll lose count. So I'm gonna eyeball it really quick. I think that's kind of short. One more. And it would be like this, because I'm not using the two buttons at the very bottom. I think I'm gonna add one more. So now I have these two here at my end. I'm gonna skip these two, and I'm gonna go through the rest of them again. Excuse me. I'm gonna go through all of these again, and I'm gonna make a loop like that. And I'm gonna finish going through them. I'm gonna pull, and I'm gonna finish going through them. And I'm going to go through them one more time so I can reinforce this, so I can have three passes of thread in my loop. Since these are the points, the areas that are going to get a lot of pull, I want to reinforce it really good. So I'm almost done, and I know this is not the most exciting part to watch, but I'm almost done going through all of them. I can feel my loop very, very sturdy, which I like. Okay, so I'm coming out of my last one of the grouping, and you can kind of tell here, coming out here, then this is where I started my loop. I want to come out, this is where I ended my loop. Once I'm at the end, and you can tell because there's a little bit of a space there, go through these two and then go down all of your beads again to reinforce this side of your necklace. So I am going to do this on camera because we're almost ended with our project. So when you do this, just make sure you get every single bead on there. I did. So now I'm going to do my next few like that. And I'm coming out here at my last 11-0, And now I'm going to remove my stop bead. It's on there pretty tight. But I got it. So my threads are meeting. And now I'm going to tie a knot. And I'm going to take off, well, I'm going to take off my needle first. I'm going to tie a knot with these two. And your threads should be meeting. And then again. And then one more time. And now I'm going to remove this with my thread burner. Yes, I left a little bit of a tail there so I can just, so I know where I'm at, so I can find it easily and I can glue it down. But this is what we have. And this lays around the neck like this. So we are done. This completes our Riviera necklace. And I'm trying to get it all here. I think you can kind of see it. But this completes our Riviera necklace. See? Pretty fast, pretty simple. So go crazy with colors. There's a bunch of colors of Round Trios that have just come out. They're gorgeous. They're lovely. And so I'm trying to stock up. Your spiky buttons, these are just cool. I like these. I hadn't used these before this project, but I have to say I really like them. And I like how they look paired with daggers. Daggers, I love them. Arcos, same thing. So I like everything. I do. I love beads. I just love beads. So have fun. Have fun. Enjoy making this. And if you have any problem, just review the video. I hope you enjoyed making this. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Thank you very much for watching.